released on the Wii U back in 2013.
Wait, it was that long ago?
Super Mario 3D World was the big hit for the console, being the next highly anticipated 3D Mario game of the generation, to live up to the likes of the previous games from its stellar 3D collection. You know, the ones where their titles or aspects has something that has a connection to the console it's on. Like Super Mario 64, because
64 bits!
Or Super Mario Sunshine, because Dolphin! Yeah, that one doesn't land all too well unless you know technical console aspects. Or you're Italian. Or both. Because one look at the title on the console, what the f*** am I supposed to know about this? Because I know what to get out of this. With 3D World, the title was based on this one, which actually made sense because of its selling point for the system. That being
stereoscopic glasses free 3D.
And this was furthermore carried into the game with puzzles and other sections of stages where the use of 3D helped with traversing and completing them. But hey, don't get me wrong, 3D World is a fun experience of expansive Mario platforming goodness to sink your teeth into for a good few hours. With its introduction of fresh ideas, level designs and an integrated world with the power-ups, levels that provide a pretty decent challenge, fun but also mildly infuriating audio player.
I tell you what, I don't know what's going on.
Oh my god.
And, okay. Don't get me started on the soundtrack, because, oh lord, it is bliss, I tell you. Genuine ear pleasure. Like, take a listen to this. That doesn't even scratch the surface of content that the game has on offer. There is just so much to take in from level to level. Except Captain Toad levels, they're just there. But unfortunately, these aspects of praise were not known to the outside world and only known to the idiots who spent money on a Wii U. And I like to boil it down to two factors, those being 1. The game being named after a previous entry, which was also a confusing choice as previously mentioned, which as a result confused many, and 2. The game existed on a home console that was selling poorly as all hell due to poor advertising, with the system struggling on life support for 5 years. Yeah, the game didn't do all too well, which is a shame because there is genuine fun to be had in this that quite a lot of people miss out on. But looking at the sales for it, yeah, it blew. But this video exists. So something good finally happened, right? What do you think? Well, with one anniversary direct and overview trailer that features a moment where a large amount of people collectively shat themselves, it arrives. Oh man, where do I begin with this? Okay. It's short, but damn is it a genuinely great experience for an already great game, just making it an already great package. But let's talk before I get ahead of myself. Yes, when I say short, I mean it, with about a total of about 3 to 4 hours for the 100% completion goal. But man, even if it's a short experience, there is just so much you can get lost in while playing. The atmosphere, the challenge, the freedom, the music. Everything about the small package just oozes Nintendo's staple charm of creativity and innovation into what they make. Even with the smallest details of cat-based hieroglyphics seen on the structures. You can even use the cats as a weapon. Oh yeah, did I mention cats? Because they're everywhere.
Even the damn bushes are cats.
But besides the catastrophe, gameplay. If you're a fan of Odyssey, then you're going to like this. Moons are like shines. And when I say shines, I mean cat shines.
Oh man, Nintendo calling about the sunshine. No way.
Go from point A to point B. Complete a small challenge. Race the clock. Stuff like that. But the difference here is how much more open it is. In Odyssey, you're confined to the one world to get your moons and take on challenges. And on some occasions, you could reach further locations of the area, but you were still confined to the one set piece of each world. And it worked for the game's theme of adventure and travel. Now, in Bowser's Fury, sure, you're confined to this one place at all times, which on the surface would seem like a downgrade. However, it's made up for it with set pieces of the place being unlocked over time. And better yet, you can choose which ones you go to in any order. If you can see it, you can go to it. You're free to go where you want and do the cat shine challenges in any order you want, and that even includes going to previous islands to get more shines. But let's not forget the twist here. On the surface, this would be a decent expansion to an already existing game, and would be a nice idea for a new open world Mario game. However, this is where the expansion's title comes into play, and what makes this side mode worth it. During your time exploring, you'll notice this giant shell just spinning. Yeah, that's Bowser.
Wait, what the fuck?
With your time spent on the island with exploration and shine collecting, he'll start rising. And you better watch out, because when it starts raining, you know it's too late.
Oh, Mamma Mia.
This is where the title comes into play because, oh my god, what even is this?
When Bowser rises, everything goes to hell in this fiery and disastrous landscape, as fire blasts at you and rocks fall from the sky.
Even the cats are evil now! But don't that even matter? Do you hear this music?
While this is happening, you have a brief period in time to get to certain areas you couldn't reach before, which helps you gather more shines, alongside having Fury Bowser to break these special Fury blocks to get further access to more shines, which in turn will turn Fury Bowser away until he comes back again, in which the process repeats. However, if you have enough cat shines, you have the chance to take on Fury Bowser one-on-one using the Giga Bell, and...
okay, this is just getting ridiculous.
You have a kaiju battle as a cat plumber.
This shit's getting out of hand.
Look at that, and tell me that's an official Mario model.
This is not even a Mario game at this point. Anyways... bada bing, bada boom.
If you've never played 3D World or just want the Fury experience, I recommend it. With Odyssey and now this, this is definitely the path for Mario's future success. Hello, this is Shuffle Persona, and I'd like to thank you all who are currently listening for watching till the end. But before the video ends, I just want to talk about a few things. Starting off with, yes, I am back to making content after my last proper video, like, 3-4 months ago. It's been quite a while, yeah. But after some creative and personal hurdles, which I'm still trying to get past. But yeah, I'm back to make content, which I hope I can do more regularly. But hey, who knows, things can happen. Before moving on, I just want to quickly mention that this Bowser's Fury video wasn't actually planned originally as the comeback. I actually had another video planned out, but with some creative issues in the script, I've had to put it on hold. So it came to Bowser's Fury as it was more fresh on my mind to talk about. So that's why this video exists. Because this video is more fresh and is my first venture into this format for content, I do want opinions from you all on what works and what not, because I do want to improve in this content style. And while I can improve in strides, getting feedback is what makes it all the better. And even liking the video and subscribing goes to show that you all are interested in this going forward. But I do want to say thank you for all of the support so far. It's genuinely appreciated, honestly. But before finishing up, I do want to thank two of my friends for being huge supporters in this video, that being Jaygo and Kalif for being involved in the multiplayer footage. Genuinely want to thank them for being open to the involvement. And also be sure to look out on the second channel where more of the footage will be used for a video, as there were funny moments that I just can't go to waste. Coming to the end now, if you want to keep up with me more online, I have a bunch of social links in the description which you can all follow, including my Ko-fi page, which includes content updates and behind the scenes extras from upcoming and previous videos. In fact, on the day this uploads, I'm actually going to make a blog post talking about some details of this video and extras very soon, so be sure to look out for that. And on the Ko-fi as well, you can support me directly with completely optional donations of any amount you choose. All supporters have their names and amounts read off at the end of each main upload, and in fact, there is a name I can read off today, that being Bellyman with a £50 donation. And while on the surface this seems like quite a lot for a first donation, the context behind that is Kalif paid me back for something I bought him. And yes, that's Kalif. But yeah, even if that's the case, I still have the obligation I've set myself to read off all Ko-fi donations in videos, so yeah, there's that. But with all that said, I hope you all enjoyed the video, and I'd like to thank you all for watching. See you next time.